how did you first become involved in permaculture, and how did you develop the project that you run now?
So I never believed God from my childhood. So that I think it's in every activity I'm a little different from the normal society and people.
Okay.
So that is how that led to me, my education. When I was in my education time also, just I was a little, lot of politics are there. Even in my student movement, I was in a very different thinking and alternative thinking. And
so what was it you studied at university?
I was studied Usmania University, is one of the renowned university in India itself. Mm-hmm. It's a good big university. I did my philosophy.
Philosophy?
Yeah, master in arts, and I did my philosophy. Then I did my barrister as a law.
Oh, yeah. Right.
So then okay. I got into the permaculture movement. It was in '86. There was a conference was going on in India. It's '85. Then I was in campus, university. There was things were going on the campus. There was a lot of people I could see, some white and black and all sorts of people. Then I asked one of the participants, what is going on the campus? What is going on the university? He said, it's some conference, some about the permaculture. So what is this permaculture? I didn't know exactly what is the permaculture talks about and says about. But we are in a university, different environment, and something is going on the campus. A lot of events will take place on universities like in India, in most of the seminars and workshops. I thought it is also one of such event, I thought. But it was long, almost 10 days, 15 days long workshop is going on. Then I happened to go that side. I have found some people. Among those people, I found Dr. Venkat. He's the person who I am seeing first time.
I met him. He's also in the film with Phil Mollison.
Exactly. The Global Gardener.
Global Gardener.
Yeah. I happened to meet, luckily, that person, but at the time I'm not very sure what aware of what is happening, what is a permaculture.
Right.
But in the same place I met, then I saw Bill Mollison and Robin Francis and these people I met there.
David Holmgren?
Yeah, David Holmgren as well. So then it's sort of some workshop, I didn't know about much agriculture, but that's I met some people, as I volunteered something to go meet people and what's happening and knowing each other, and some Indian people, as many as people are possible from different walks of life, and some agriculture people and some academic background people. Everybody was there actually. So I able to meet some of them, and then I was not so keen to permaculture at all. But after 1 year, 2 years, this happened to me, after my campus, my university life, my student life, I wanted to happen to go one of the NGO where the Venkat is working. That is called a Deccan Development Society. It was an NGDA. There was the Venkat is working with those groups. So he's doing a lot of work in the gardens and food forest and vegetable kitchen gardens and planting trees, and he was talking about various things. So we are living together, but not what the subject exactly, I didn't know much about, but we were staying together in I was staying next to his room in the morning, having a cup of tea and talking about permaculture. All the time he's in the garden. I think this old man, why is a mad fellow? He's all the time, instead of sitting under a tree and talking to people, he's talking to the trees. He's going in all the time in the trees, and he's talking about trees and looking at them, planting something. I think he's a very crazy, I thought. So it's happened to go along with sometimes what's happening in the garden. He was developing a farm where we are working at that time. So he planted all the permaculture principles, and he's talking about various things, and he's talking. That one day Venkat has left his signature on the table. So I have taken that signature, I went to the plant and I pruning the trees. So I didn't know, it should not be pruned, I didn't know, but since it is a signature, that's meant for prune something. So I did all the plants pruned.
We shouldn't give you a pair of secateurs here, you could just start cutting them.
Yeah, exactly, that's what happened. The moment it came and I put there again. The Venkat came back to his that garden, he came, asked, who did does all these cuttings and pruning. And one person who is working with us, who looks after the farm, he said, Narsana, cut all these things. So, okay, Jinsen, on the good morning, so I met there having a cup of tea. So, Narsana, you come here. So, what's up? Did you ever seen the forest? Any trees have been pruned? I don't know, first of all. I haven't seen any tree has pruned or not. Why did you ask him, sir, this one? Yesterday you did great mistake. You have taken my secateur, you all pruned your coconut tree's leaves. Next time if you do it, it's a big sin. Don't do that. In permaculture, pruning is the trees they don't like you are cutting your fingers and your hands. You can't stand properly. If you cut your hands, your fingers, your legs, your hair, it looks very ugly and you can't do your own thing. That is how plant also is. Plant life is such, as such. So you should not cut anything. Let it grow in the natural environment. They will take their own shape. They have their own living lifestyle. How to grow, what to grow, what not to grow, which side, which direction, where they like. He's explained about the plants, the characters, the forest, what it, how that is. So like that, so many, then why this guy is talking about, I didn't understand. What is the driver? The forest, so many trees are there, why he's asking? So like that, slowly some interaction built, and I started working with him in the garden. We developed a farm where Bill Mollison came, and he has done some lot of the Gangamma Mandala. One way of a design is a Gangamma Mandala is the center. There will be a bowl shaped pit, and you have to scoop them and put your soil up, and around that you make a compost pit, and you make a pathway around it, and then you make a keyholes around it. Is an easy way of access to your kitchen garden, and you can use, and it's very efficient.
You have a tree in the middle.
In the middle tree, or just you make it as a center here, scooped area is for your all the dumping, all the organic waste of your weeds and anything put there, and you become compost, and you need not to go from that Gangamma Mandala very far away to get the manure. Just you be stand at one point, you can harvest, you can water, you can weed it, you can put there, and you can manure again, same manure will go back there. I think at one standing point, you can do many things. That's the energy conservation way of vegetables, that's one of the models. So that's Gangamma Mandala, by the time I have seen it, it's a good, I think. That's how I started involved with the slowly permaculture, what it does. Then we started moving to the communities and doing some vegetables at the backyards, and that is how people are knowing about permaculture world, and then they are very access to the vegetable seeds and eating some vegetables, creepers and greens, such things. It was in 87. I was, that is the only job. So I was, where I'm working at the organization, there are a lot of other activities. But Venkat said, no, you should exclusively, Narsana will be the coordinator for permaculture activity, no other job. Because if you deviate from your thing, I think it's a hobby thing. No, it has to be focused on a permaculture activity, nothing else. So that is a concentration. Don't involve the others also. He said, don't involve Narsana in other activities because it is a dilute his concentration. So exclusively for permaculture project, growing food, talking to farmers, women, groups, and vegetable growing, and some seeds, and planting, and designs, and design of farmland, and wastelands to be greening. So these activities should not be taken. So that is what the slogan. So I was working with the bank. So advantage thing was that most of them working with the women groups. That is a great advantage, and they are the people, those who make success of all these activities. They have capacity to do that, because they will take care of your family means is they will take care of the plants and what the food requirement around your house. I think they are the producer, they are the managers, and they are the people who will take forward any concept. I think the right people got in right time, and that is how we slowly got into the different people, different communities, different section of the people. I think that is advantage with us. So at that time, I think we started the work, I think very small, when we are going with a small pack with a small seed. If you might open my bag, all boxes with some seeds. If anybody comes and water the seed, just I used to go to their house. So around their house, I'm digging and planting something. That is how the movement has started slowly. Just it's now working on the own land, it's our national land. Then next, go to the kitchen gardens. Then slowly we moved on to their small holdings. Then it's community. So there is the steps, the step-by-step approach to leads to the communities.
Yeah.
So not immediately getting into the people is not possible because our capacities are not that extent. Mm-hmm. And it's very minimal resources, Venkat and myself are the two people. But our strength is the communities. If you do with community, they are the real people to do it, and they will do it for their own, not for somebody. But we will do most of the work for somebody. Somebody means we to show. That's what the model forms on our own forms. But the model is very wrong word to use. It should not be a model, it should be functional.
Okay.
Suppose if you have a developing a form, it's not to show me. Is a really functional is going on. You are growing something, you are eating them.
Really?
Not to show this is the herb is for this and that, this is a vegetable for this and that.
Mm.
Not to show people convince permaculture. It's a functional.
Mm-hmm.
It's getting food from here, they can take them and they're using.
Yeah.
That is how your system should go in. Otherwise, and, not for the demonstration as well.
Multiple functions.
They're able to eat what your body requires.
Yeah.
So in India, is the growing as a vegetable. We'll call them as a vegetable kitchen garden. Our problem is the field. Huge stacks of your staple food like your brassica is there.
Yeah.
And your seed, mustard is wild, straight ripe, and your wheat. And these are the tracts of sack land. We need in India, we have not shortage of this, but the people, those who are living in the communities, they need your cereal, pulses, azils, oil seeds,
right.
Some vegetables.
Yeah.
But the vegetables, why we do not grow separately? Because in India, all these crops, along with that crop, some greens will grow. They need not to grow separately vegetables.
Mm. Mm.
Because when you are doing agriculture, when you are doing the crops, along with the crops, you will get a lot of weeds. We'll call them as a vegetable almost. You are then weeds.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But in India, there is a tropical country. Luckily, is a tropical country. There is an advantage of every season has their own weeds and plants.
Everything so grows a lot more quickly.
More quickly and more resilient to this thing, and is more nutritious. When they will go for labor, the women, while they are coming back to home, they pick up some greens. They do work, and while they are coming, whatever the unwanted they are saying, the unwanted things they will collect and they'll come in back and they'll cook and they eat.
So they forage on the way home.
Exactly, home, yeah, exactly. So that is how the advantage. We are not much concentrated in the growing vegetable. The most of them, we are calling them weeds are unwanted. They're most of the 90% of the weeds are edible.
Yeah.
And the edible, if even whatever the 10% is by, not maybe by humans, but it by cattle.
Mm-hmm.
Because our part of our life, the cattle rearing in our cultures are part of our life. There will be some buffalo, or sheep, or goat, or your bullocks, or in oxes, cows. This is part of the goats and sheep.
Yeah.
Is a part of our culture.
Are they used for meat or?
Meat and some work. If you come to the cattle, cow is for the cow, have a calf and give it to the multiplication of, multiply their cattle population and as well milk as well.
Mm-hmm.
And your cow dung is very expensive nowadays because it's a good source for our fields.
Yeah.
And your bullocks for the plowing, they do work. There's a lot of manure.
Yeah. Yeah.
And buffalo for your dung as well. They give a lot of milk. That is an income generating activity. We'll sell the market, the milk in the market, and we'll get money and feed them.
Yeah.
So like that, goat even for meat. Goat and sheep is basically for the meat, and we'll sell it to the market. They'll get a good amount of money.
Right.
So like that, the animals do as a for money and for the dung, for the manure, and your from work, agriculture work. These three levels of work they do.
Right.
Not simply is only the meat.
Yeah. Right.
Because throughout his life, it's 15 years, suppose, if I have a buffalo.
Yeah.
Throughout 15 years, if you collect, if you put it to the compost, the amount of manure I'm using is 10 times more than the cost of your buffalo. So like that, just is a way of life is totally different. We'll integrate with the even family means not only agriculture. Agriculture is the plowing land, you have having some animals and you are having some chickens.
Yes.
That is how the life will go on. Not only totally depend on agriculture is not possible because the activities, the elite activities like an animal husbandry and your chickens and your labor and you have to go for wage to get money, you have to do your grow own feed and staple food, any excess you have to sell it market. This is how the life of the rural communities will do, they do. So that is how slowly we got it involved with the taking care of not only agriculture, animal integration, tree-based farming.
Are you able to design the animals into the permaculture system?
Exactly.
So they become
part of your systems.
Otherwise
how can you manage a farm? If you won't have that animal integration in your permaculture systems or any system, it is not sustainable. You have to integrate your animal into it will plow, not plow your you feed all the agriculture waste which we are talking, you feed them, they will give your milk as well your consumption for your children as a healthiness and the body requires it. And at the same time it will give manure for the put back to your soil. Again you have to grow them and you have to eat them. This cycle will continue integration of your animal into your farming system.
It's a very sustainable system.
Very sustainable system in the rural community because they look at not only the one aspect, they have to livelihood and some product of it to put back to the soil. That's how you have to create the models and your patterns. You are designed in such a way they should not eat what you need for farm. You should be able to get them on the farm itself, not from external, not external inputs to come and everything is coming. Today what's happening, agriculture, this is what exactly happening. What's happening, everything you have to get from outside. Your labor should come outside, your plowing tractor will come outside, your all your fertilizers, everything. So I think how does it sustain it? I think it's not that possible. I think that's how in that such environment your things, your ideology will not work. When you are working with the communities, you have to be with, because that is how your nature is. Nature is a mix of all your animals and trees and plants and edibles, everything. That is how you have to create a farm when you are doing with the community. You have to integrate all these things. Already it is there, you need not to integrate much. Because you have to protect them, you have to continue that cultures to take forward.
Is it very challenging getting people to think that way?
For me, it is not difficult as such. If I work within a different communities, as you said, all this have come, but the indigenous and rural tribal still not that gone that extent. Still they are in the control of various things what you are talking about. So is they are in a moving. If I won't go there, they would have moved in a different direction of going for fertilizers and pesticides and different commercial crops. But I moved, I have gone by the time they are in the right track. I think that's the advantage with the indigenous people and the tribal people. If I would have gone to other communities, definitely they have a big problem for me to convince them on different various issues. But there are some people, even the communities, in the rural tribal communities, they have gone for commercial crops, they are bringing a lot of synthetic pesticides and fertilizer they are using, and they are finally they are not able to meet their needs, and they are in debt, and they are committing suicides, and lot such cases are there. But it's very not that if you compare with the different communities, and there is a big lot families and farmers where they are doing commercial crops and monocrops, there they have a lot of problem. Particularly you need a lot of commercial crops needs a lot of requirements like your resources, like your fertilizers, money, water, labor. It's very intensive. In that case, I think they have to be very, very alternative thinking. I am meeting regularly some people, I talk to them. But I think these days I've gone talking to people. I think they wanted to see more than the listen. Because they're live examples. They're learning by doing. And believing by seeing. Seeing is believing. My first basic fundamental question, you should grow something or else. Otherwise, just living, you see every inch of land you brought under cultivation, you are growing something or other. That is make sense of your Mother Earth will be happy with that. Just don't insult it, don't it's a ridiculous leaving the land and not without doing anything.
Mm.
It's a just is a keep is a resource to grow something. Not keeping the land is a fallow.
Mm.
That's where you have to your systems. Not even crops. You can grow some trees,
mm.
which is useful to the
yeah.
community as
yeah.
well, and some your environment. If you're not using, that is a nothing but is a insulting the
mm-hmm.
resource.
Yeah.
That I think that relationship should not be continued.
Yeah.
We have to break somewhere by doing some activity over that land.
Yeah.
What type of agriculture later comes? But that is a understanding with who. Then we have to slowly communicate, and already they have practices, some of them taken wrong.
Yeah.
That's what in the tribal community I was doing that. They don't have, they are living in the forest, but they think that, oh, always we are living in the forest, why should we grow the trees? Only I want is 1 hectare of wheat or some sorghum, some millet. I don't want any trees in the on my garden because it provides a lot of shade. Trees means they think it's a huge trees. No. You have to, the perennials must have in your farm land.
Yeah.
Otherwise, without perennials, if you
yeah.
go only annuals, I think that do not do thrive well and they are not happy.
Mm.
They may give some production, but they are not happy.
Mm.
We don't know the language of trees. What it says, they don't have to speak.
Mm.
But we try to understand the language of plants even.
Mm.
What they say, whether they are happy or not.
Mm.
By seeing the healthiness and their bloom and very happy, if you get into the forest, in the garden, they're all nicely, they're very happy. If you look at, just you stay for 15 minutes or 10 minutes or 5 minutes, I think they're looking very happy because
yeah.
you are with them.
Yeah.
Somebody's there, know that somebody's taking care of me.
Yeah.
So that is a relationship, the plant and human, but more than, that has to continue.
Yeah.
If that is not relationship, I think we are more than cooperating, more than taking protection and protecting them, we are distracting the most of the practices.
Mm-hmm.
And we are disastrous way of approaches we have taken in the human activities. I think that is we have to stop. We have to work with the cooperation with the nature, not against. That's what the nature law says about it.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
the permaculture says about
yeah.
it. That is how my communities are moving ahead, and they are doing better job. Let us see how the tree-based farming will lead to their some livelihood, some subsistence and some sustainable way of farming systems of their own land. They will be able to get some food as well as some fruits and some perennial cropping system. They ensure their food security. Anywhere if it goes, I say the only thing. You try to understand the earth, what it meant for. You try to understand the nature. You try to, nature means you include, you put, it comes, it includes everything. The world is just what is our education, our books says about nature is something, nothing is somewhere else. This way we are living in this nature. How best you can use that resources and you grow your own food, what way you are growing is later. But you have to grow your own food and it's living with the communities and in a better way rather than doing all your ways of life is uncertainty. That should not be in your life. There is a certain things which I can do for my own, to my food, and I can help the farmers in those who are doing gardening in your context. My I think is the farmer in my India,
mm-hmm.
but you will talk as your neighbor.
Mm-hmm.
What is that doing? The relationship you maintain and you grow your own food and you better you try to help others and this nature will accept it. Otherwise, I think we are more than the taking resources, we are not giving back to the anything near nature.
Mm.
So that's what the villagers or your town and urban, semi-urban or rural communities, I think that is how what they have to do. Particularly UK people, as I think very, they have resources, they can do better things, not directly, indirectly, they can help some communities where they are doing like this community gardens, they have to help them to grow more food since they are not able to practice participate in the production, food production.
Yes.
They can support the communities, that is how they are able to get healthy food or healthy thinking, healthy people. That is how the societies will build up.
What is personally your favorite permaculture principle?
Okay, among all these things?
Among all the
permaculture principles. Okay, the tree-based farming I like. Perennials. In the nature it is there. but you are losing the perennial way of life, because not only is it's linked up with your soils and environment, because the trees, the perennials, they have a lot of advantage with the gardening, your fields, because they are the species which they look up your soil health and your environment and your microclimates. They will create more your natural predators,
yeah.
And they are the hosting your all these your elements into your farming system. Within the trees, within the herbs, within the shrubs, you maximize the. Even if I take a herb, I think you have a plenty of. Not only one herb I can have enough. No, it's not like that. Within the herbs, there are number of species.
Hundreds of.
Diversity is required. Mm. If I grow a tree, the tree is not one. You hundreds of varieties are there.
Mm.
You grow them because one varieties doesn't work.
Mm.
And you are, take a cereals, not one cereal. You grow as many as cereals are possible. And again, they need a diversity. As your food you are taking, you are not only eating your food, rice or sorghum or your bread, your wheat. You are adding so many things into it. Then only you are feeling is taste, and you are eating more, and you are keeping your health is better.
Mm.
So like is your environment where you are living, that has to be diversified, as not in a solo or a mono way of approach. It doesn't work. I like that way of
great
practice of permaculture.
Wonderful.
Diversity in life.
All right.
Good.
Okay.
Fantastic. Thank you very much.